In this lesson we will also do the FMC installation. Before we do the installation, we need to create VLAN groups on the ESXi side. I have created these VLAN groups before. Let me show you the groups I have created. Here you can see the VLAN groups I have created. You create these VLAN groups before you start the installation and then you start the installation. Now let's come to the virtual server side and start creating our server here. Let's start the installation here by saying create. I select the deploy virtual machine OVF or OVA file. I say next. From here we select the OVF file that we are going to upload. Here I open the Firepower Management Center folder. In this folder we will select the ESXi OVF file and our virtual disk. After selecting the two files, I continue. Let's write our name, FMC. I say next. Let's choose the data store where we will install. Let's say next. In our management port we will select VLAN 16. That is, we will use the subnet 172.16.0.0. Here I say next, I'm removing it from power on auto selected. I start the import process by saying finish. Here you can follow the import process. Our import process has been successfully completed. Let's start the installation by saying power on to our server. Our installation now continues in the background. After the installation we will connect to the web interface by making the interface settings. After waiting for about 30 to 40 minutes, we came to the login screen. Here we will make our first settings by entering our username and password. Our username in default is admin. In our password it is admin123 and its A is large. Here he asks us to read and accept the license agreement. Let's continue by saying enter. Let's enter a new password. It is geek to have at least 8 characters, uppercase letters, lowercase letters, numbers and special characters. Now let's give the host name of our device. Let the host name be FMC. I say enter. We need to type in the IP address manually here, as we will be setting it manually. I say enter. Our IP address will be 172.16.0.200. After giving the IP address we also write down our subnet mask, our gateway and then the DNS server address in the local. Then we also write down our NTP address. I typed in an NTP server address on the internet. We finish our transactions by saying yes. After finishing our procedures, let's wait about 5 minutes and finish our lesson by connecting to the web interface. I access the Cisco Firepower Management Center interface by entering the IP address 172.16.0.200 management interface in the web browser. That's all we'll tell you in this lesson for now, so goodbye to see you in our next lesson.